Hello, Home Trees. It's your host, Chris, Corey, and Donnie. Welcome to another Goodie Bag edition of the More Gooder Than podcast. On these extrasodes, we reveal the moves for the next main episode, read your comments, never listen to messages from the hotline, and do another segment of MGT Light where it is where we do things. We discuss something we've been into during the week, but not Endgame, because I'm the only one that's seated in this room. So still, so no spoilers.
We can talk about GOT, but not Endgame.
We can talk about, someone said about Game of Thrones that, like, it's been 5 days. It's a weekly thing. Mm-hmm. Like, it's, you can talk. You're allowed to have spoilers.
Yeah.
It's a...
And this will come out after the follow-up episode of the...
What's the next one called?
I don't know.
What's
don't know
what's tomorrow's
I'm
called?
A nerd.
I'm not a nerd. I just cosplay. Oh, man. So next week's episode is called And the Oscar Goes To. Do you like that voice?
Yeah.
It's fun. And we'll feature the films.
No, it's And the Oscar Goes To Isaac.
Oh, that's what it is?
Yeah, because he's Oscar.
And the Oscar Isaac. Goes To Isaac. Okay. Let me put that in to my notes. I like this title less now.
Oh, really?
I'm just messing
that's,
with you.
That's why I asked. I did it. And the Oscar Goes To ......
Isaac. Okay. And we'll feature the films Ex Machina, Annihilation, and Sucker Punch, all featuring
Oscar Isaac.
Oscar Isaac.
How amazing is he?
69. Giggity. 69. Giggity.
How awesome is he, though?
Just amazing.
He's really good, right?
Poe.
He's strange looking.
But he's so, but doesn't matter.
But he's got that, like, look where, like, he can really kind of play any race.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
He's like Alfred Molina. He was Doc Ock in Spider-Man 2.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, I have seen Alfred Molina play just straight white dude.
Yeah.
He's ethnically ambiguous.
Foppish British man. And then, like, from the 1800s. And then Prince of Persia, he was a Persian, like, bazaar dealer.
When Doc Ock is, like, Slavic or something, right?
Octavius. Whatever Octavius is.
Wherever that's from.
Whatever that's from. But we're not talking about Alfred Molina.
No.
We're talking about
Oscar Isaac.
Poe Dameron himself. What's the first time you guys saw Oscar Isaac?
Sucker Punch is the first.
I think the same for me as well.
I didn't realize who he was because he wasn't anybody then.
No,
and
at
I
that
just
point.
Remember, well, I'm a spoiler for the next episode, but I mean, I really liked that movie and I just thought, like, this, like, no name guy is doing an amazing performance. And then over time, he started coming out in other stuff and I didn't even put it together that that's who it was. And it wasn't until I watched the How Did This Get Made episode that they were talking about Oscar Isaac.
And
they
were
all
June,
like, really in love with him.
June was in to creepy Oscar Isaac.
I hadn't seen any of these movies, so I think the Star Wars stuff is the only thing.
The first thing.
Things I'd seen him in.
Yeah.
Man,
the first and only until this week.
What a fantastic journey you went on this.
Right? Yeah.
Like, geez Louise. Because, like, for me, it was the opposite. I had seen all three of these. And, like, when you had, we'd had another episode planned for 69, but it fell through. And I'll talk about that next week. We were thinking of them and Corey's like, oh, let's do that Oscar Isaac episode. I'm like, yes, right. So we can finally talk to someone about Annihilation besides Elise. Cause like, she's like one of the only people that in my circle that have seen it.
Okay.
So I'm like, thank you. Definitely yes. Talk. Please watch it. So for me, I'd seen all three recently.
Yeah.
So it was like, this is really easy to prep for.
Yeah.
So, but anyway, next week, Ex Machina, Annihilation, and Sucker Punch. It's going to be good. The Oscar goes to Isaac. I'm going to really emphasize the .. A Twitter poll was ran.
Run that.
That was, do you guys remember when we did the Jim Carrey episode?
I was trying to remember what movies we did.
I was thinking about.
That was eons ago.
Yeah. Millennium Falcons ago.
I look there when I'm thinking. Yeah. Corey and I do the same thing.
Oh, we're looking at the same spot. That must be like a concentration of, like, energy or something.
I look at the Nebula.
The Nebula Cruiser.
Nebula Cruiser.
What they're referencing is that if they're thinking, both of them do a very specific thing. They look at this. They look at this spot, like, look away.
Yeah.
And it's usually like when we're trying to come up with a title
or remember something.
Like, they just, like, pause and they look at this spot.
I actually think it's probably more of a social construct. It's basically to let others around you know that, like, oh, I'm in deep concentration.
Don't interrupt me right now.
Well, I'm not going to respond to anything you're saying to me because I'm thinking. Yeah.
Well, it's a subconscious thing that you're doing.
Yeah.
You're not doing it on purpose. Like, I'm going to look away. Oh, shut up, everybody.
I've been doing that for, like, years now, probably, but only realize it because you just pointed that out, like, 5 minutes ago.
Well, yeah. Yeah. The thing is, so Donnie sits to my right. Corey sits directly in front of me. So I have to crane my neck to look at Donnie. Mm-hmm. And so I never look at Donnie. Oh,
part of our plan to give right. Chris spinal problems.
Yeah, I know. Go to the chiropractor. You have a weird crick in your neck. What are you doing? Are you always slightly looking to the right and turning your head to make sure you stay on a mic? Yeah, that's oddly specific, Doc.
The sole reason we started this podcast.
To screw with. There was my brother
his
and me.
His posture is too good. We need to do something about that.
He is so straight in the spinal area. Mission accomplished. And they were talking about this guy brought up a question like, my boyfriend eats raw fettuccine and calls it chips. Hmm. Yeah, I know, right? It's horrible.
Yeah.
And so that sounds miserable. And so then the older brother, Justin and Travis, are like, oh yeah, you're a monster. That's disgusting. And it's
like,
your boyfriend.
When, like, I get pasta at a restaurant and they've like cooked it, I think they call it al dente where it's like slightly undercooked.
No,
you gotta like, get it. I just want to like kill myself instantly. It's so awful. It just like sticks in your teeth. I can't imagine.
You take that strong fettuccine streak
and stick it right in my jugular.
No, and then you wrap it around your neck and hang yourself right there with the fettuccine.
It's just strong enough to hang.
If you look at Olive of Olive Garden, this is your fault.
What's that disorder called? Like pico something?
Pica.
Yeah.
Pico de gallo?
Yeah. Pica de gallo.
Pica de gallo.
It's where you make salsas.
You make salsa out of like rocks.
Rocks
and
like gravel.
You feel a need to eat stuff you should be eating.
Inorganic material.
Yeah.
And so then Griffin looks at him and says, oh, that's not weird. Like they used to have like the box at the front that you would eat out of. And he looked at their brother and says, wait a second. Did you trick me in eating raw uncooked pasta? And they're like, you're welcome. That's why you have IBS. Anyway, a Twitter poll was ran for a Jim Carrey episode.
Yeah.
You guys remember when we did that?
Yeah, it was like so long ago.
It was a long time ago.
It was like last year, wasn't it?
Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind won with 51%. Truman Show with 46%. So that's really close, which means that The Majestic almost
not
a zero.
Super popular.
3% I've been doing some Twitter polls for the Facebook home trees. I really just focus on the Twitter poll because it's easy to screenshot.
Yeah.
And I just remember all of these years, like just having this fond memory of The Majestic, thinking like, this is a really good movie. And then I watched it again this time and I'm like, huh, I was mistaken.
It was a good movie.
It was exactly.
But Truman Show and
Eternal Sunshine
are amazing.
You know, incredible films.
I agree. It wasn't bad. I had a higher expectation going in. So that's why I'm probably being a little harsher on it. It's problematic for me.
This is when we did, because you'd seen it before.
Yeah.
I was right. We should have done Cable Guy.
Which is not a funny movie.
Yeah.
At all.
It's not funny, okay. Jim Carrey.
The thing is, though.
It's a little creepy, though. Like
the funniest part of the entire movie is when they're playing dirty charades or dirty password. The password is nipple. And he's playing with his mom. Do you guys not remember Cable Guy?
I've seen it.
Once. I never actually saw it.
I've never seen
it. One time.
So they're playing. So he inserts himself into his family. What about Bob style?
Yeah.
And they're playing dirty password or adult password or whatever. Yeah. And the password is nipple. And he's trying to describe it. He's trying. And his mom is his partner. And he's trying to get his mom to say nipple. He's like, center. Anyway, it's really funny.
Who is the? Oh, it's
Matthew Broderick.
Matthew Broderick. Yeah.
No. Oh, I thought it was Ben Stiller.
No.
I mean, at that point,
they were the same person.
They were doing that trajectory had not happened. It's similar to the Val Kilmer, Robert Downey Jr. You know, as Val Kilmer's star goes down, but Robert Downey Jr.
They're crossfading,
and they cross paths.
Is that that intersection?
Kiss, bang, bang. When we're on the trajectory,
which is a great movie.
Gosh, it's a good movie. On the Facebook polls, zero votes for Majestic. Wow. But Zach from Dungeons & Dragons, he said, like, I know that Majestic has zero votes, but it is a really good movie.
Yeah.
And that's true. It's similar to me when we did the Nailed It, the John Carpenter episode, where we had Halloween and The Thing.
Yeah.
And then you had at the very bottom, They Live. I love that movie. I absolutely love it. But you can't
put one. I feel like I will go back and see it again.
It's not on the same level as those two. Halloween is like genre defining. Yeah. And
the thing is like one of the best movies.
It's like, it's incredible. So anyway,
the thing was better than I even imagined. And you guys talked it up pretty big.
I hadn't seen it either. He talked it up. Yeah.
But you knew about it. I honestly, I didn't know anything about it.
I just knew Kurt Russell was in it. And then there was an alien.
I didn't know.
That's all I knew. I
didn't know that movie was a thing. I didn't know it existed.
Now it's the thing.
Now it's the thing, yeah.
that was a good episode.
Yeah.
I've been going through thinking about what my favorite episode is. And for the reason of it introducing me to certain things, that might be my top.
Both Kurt Russell episodes, I mean, one of them wasn't solely Kurt Russell, but wasn't he in two of those as well, or maybe just one?
The Kurt Locker?
No, the Kurt Locker was the first one. I guess he was only in the thing in the John Carpenter one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the other escape movies were John Carpenter movies.
I still think of...
I know, right?
I still think of the John Carpenter episode as kind of a Kurt Russell episode as well.
I know, right?
Then we did
Stargate.
The hip, yeah.
There's a chance that Kurt Russell's been in the most movies that we've seen.
We should figure that out, huh?
We will.
Interesting.
Yeah. Home Trees, get on that. Yeah. Who have we talked about the most?
We have any prizes to give away?
Well, no. Alan Rickman, obviously, is the one that's in the most.
We did
three full episodes plus the Harry Potter series.
Oh, yeah. Did you count those movies individually?
Okay. Setting aside.
Did you do that on purpose or no?
Yes, I did that totally on purpose. Because I'm clever.
That's so good.
That's an unfair advantage, though. Setting aside Rickman, it may be Kurt Russell.
I know, yeah. Which is funny because Alan Rickman is not my favorite.
I see, there's an asterisk next to Alan Rickman because we purposefully did that.
Yeah.
Kurt Russell, just by chance, has happened to be
in Hateful Eight as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, we did have an episode called The Kurt Locker. It was.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, you're right.
But I mean, we also did Bill Paxton and others. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know if we can exempt.
Paxton's been in a lot of our movies too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Again, by chance.
It's just,
I mean, it's clear why we do specific episodes for these guys because we like them.
Really like them. Yeah. All right, it's just that they choose really good movies. There was a
they pick the movies that just end up doing really well, and we end up liking a lot. So or like they're smart actors,
or they work well with certain directors. Like you get Samuel L. He's been in the Tarantino family, since the beginning, really. And so you're always going to, he's going
to. In a way, you can almost do that too. Like we feature specific directors and producers because we like often. what they produce.
Yeah.
And so the smart actors pair themselves up with those guys and just keep making hits.
Keep working with them.
Actually, now that I think about it, I'm pretty sure Clancy Brown has starred in every movie we've ever done.
He's every
According to me, because I see him everywhere.
So Corey does not know who Clancy Brown looks like. Now he does, for sure. He'll never forget.
I went back and looked at the clip, and like that guy, like it's not Clancy Brown. It's clearly not. But like for some reason in my mind, he fit that archetype. And so I just thought like, oh, that's Clancy Brown.
Clancy Brown is one of the most... Yeah. His face, I could pick it out of any crowd. It's like he has a Skeletor mask on at all times. And that voice. Yeah. What's the name of... whatever. Highlander.
Highlander.
We started watching Highlander the other day.
Yeah.
Because Elise didn't watch it with me. And I was trying to... Because we'd watched Bohemian Rhapsody. And so she heard Who Wants to Live Forever. She's, oh, that's the first time I've heard that song. I'm like, wait, no, it's in Highlander. She's, oh, I didn't watch it. So we started watching it, and I watched it with her for the first time. I'm like, oh, my gosh, this movie is so bad. Yeah. But I love it. And there's no dialogue in the first, half hour.
Yeah.
Except for, really bad LGBTQ slurs. a lot of them. Anyway.
The first time I heard that song was, you ever heard of the Breaking Benjamin cover of that song?
Oh, yeah.
Do you like Breaking Benjamin?
I do not. Awesome? I do not like them.
Fun story about how they got their name.
I just wanted to bring that back.
Oh, man.
When they were first starting out and they were buying their equipment, all they had were hundreds. And so they had to break those Benjamins.
Oh, you gotta break those Benjamins. I want to bring up, too.
We should come up with a different Breaking Benjamin story every episode.
So what happened was
Clancy Brown somewhere.
Yes. So Clancy Brown.
He was originally their manager.
Originally in the band.
Yeah.
And all of his songs sounded like this. Ramirez. That's it.
Breaking Brown.
That was the name
band.
Of.
Yeah. Yeah.
Breaking Brown.
Breaking Brown. And everyone's like Clancy.
It's all about them Browns.
All About the
See, so it's All About the Benjamins was the first song, but all I know is All About the Pentiums, the Weird Al cover version of it.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. All About the Pentiums, see, all I think
about it's All About the Hamiltons from Lazy Sunday.
Oh, man, dang it, that's really good.
Come on, let's keep this going. How many tangents can we just go off of?
It's all about the bass, too. That bass. No trouble, though.
No trouble.
Twitter poll, Eternal Sunshine, 51%. Mike from Bad Reception Podcast says, how do I feel about this episode? Mikey likes it. He says, however, I think season 6 and 7 of Buffy are amazing. They are really good.
Yeah.
He's like, it's just like, oh, it doesn't same quality. But anyway, I
found them satisfying.
I really enjoyed them.
Yeah,
for sure. But I do agree that 5 is the best and 1 should be skipped. You definitely can skip 1.
Yeah.
Also, Buffy rules forever with a 4. Greatest show of all time. Weed and Life, hashtag Grog. That's
all references, stuff. I do not
You guess. Do not know them. The Knight Riders, the Champa, the old Champa, Cisco forever, DS9 rules. He agrees. Absolutely jumped from the pilot to season 2 finale. It's a long time ago for us because we recorded this episode a long time. But he agrees. Like, just do the season 2 finale. There is legit nothing of importance in the in-between for Deep Space Nine.
Yeah.
That has come up a lot lately. It just, okay, here's the thing. My completionist way of doing things, it kills me to do that. Like, oh, I'm going to skip. What if I miss a nuance?
I'm a recovering completionist myself. I've had to just with age and the lack of time and so many great like IPs that have come out and all forms of media that I've had to like force myself to not be a completionist.
That happened
because
with
you can't get through everything.
Well, God of War 4.
In the case of like DS, I've seen them all.
Right.
So rewatching, you know, I'm going to skip the standalone consequence episodes.
For sure. Yeah. We've been watching TNG with the girls. The girls love it. Oh my gosh.
They're like 99% standalone, no consequence.
Exactly. Yeah. So on that same list, it said, oh, if you don't want to just watch Monster of the Week style TNG, watch these episodes.
Watch Redemption 1 and 2.
Exactly. There you go.
Just watch Redemption 1 and 2.
That's so good. Yeah. That's just funny that everyone was on board with that. It's very specific because I love Star Trek. I really, really do. Yeah. Like, and it's definitely, it's a fantastic background show because there's usually nothing
kid friendly too. For the most part.
Nothing particularly scary. We did try watching some Borg episodes. That was shut down fast by the girls. They were like, they noped out so hard. I'm just trying to explain, like, remember, these are just guys. Like, but it's like, then you think about it, you're like, no, those guys are scary. Yeah. Like, that's scary. They also hate Q. Every time Q's on screen, oh, Q, get out of here. They have the exact Picard reaction. Q, what are you doing here?
I don't remember because it's honestly been a long time since I've really gotten into Trek. Q, did they ever reveal what Q was? Is he a specific kind of race?
Yeah, he's a Q.
He's a Q.
That's literally
the only from one the
Q.
No,
from the Q, they're all Q.
Yeah.
So there's multiple.
There's multiple.
They're
Qs.
Just as, like this near omnipotent race.
That's what I was wondering. Like, did they reveal him as like, oh, he's a god, or is he actually?
No,
like
literally,
an alien
the first time you see
form?
Him, he tells him exactly what he is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. It's the first episode.
Oh, I keep in mind, I watched this when I was like 15.
Let's
like,
go watch it right now. So ready? Pause it. Ready? Come back.
Okay. Yeah.
So how did you feel about Q?
Oh, back. Yeah. Oh, man, I watched the entire full, all the episodes of TNG.
Yeah. And there's a lot of them.
Yeah.
There's a lot.
So Redemption 1 and 2, right?
You're really good, right?
So good. Yeah.
The girl's favorite is this one called When the Bow Breaks. And it's funny too. It's when they steal all the children to populate this planet because they can't have kids. The Altaians.
And the children can't have kids either.
And so then it's supposed to be that like, oh, these Altaians can't have kids. So they need the kids from the Enterprise. So they just take them.
So they just have kids.
Yeah.
And then raise them like in their culture.
Exactly.
Okay, I see.
And so
thought you were saying like, cause you said to repopulate the planet, like no, kids I can't understand. Have children.
It's
either.
Got a while. Babies having babies. Is Jim Carrey handsome? Twitter poll says 50-50.
Really?
50-50. So the jury's still out.
That's legit.
Yeah. It's about right.
He's half handsome.
I don't think he's ugly.
No, I don't think he's ugly.
But
either.
There's a difference between being ugly
and handsome.
Yeah. There is a difference.
Yeah, and we were specifically saying like if he wasn't funny, would he be handsome?
Right.
Like we're taking the funny element out of the equation of attractiveness.
When he's being funny, he's less handsome. When he's all rubber faced and like,
I thought he was handsome in Eternal Sunshine.
Yeah.
Now he's got that. He was magnificent beard.
Not remarkable, but like if you just saw the dude on the street, oh yeah, it's a handsome guy.
It's not like he's a Hemsworth or something like that, well, like running around. But
obviously. That's like peak genetic
perfection.
Possibility. That is absolute genetic perfection.
Do you remember the Saturday Night Live skit where he comes in? He's like, oh man, you talking about how hard it was to get into Hollywood. I had to wait 2 whole days to be cast. And he says, it's just like, it's hard for a completely jacked Australian with a giant penis to make it in Hollywood. When I sat down to be cast for Thor, the producer says, we wanted to cast an actor that looked like Thor, not the actual God of Thunder. We all laughed and laughed and laughed. And then they gave me a huge pile of money.
Yeah.
You think I can get more handsome? Put sunglasses. Boom. It's
funny because it's true.
He's a great guy too.
Somebody posted something on Imgur yesterday. It was like a news article from 2008 or whatever, like Marvel rolling the dice.
Yes!
Casting unknowns for Thor. So it was an article about Chris Hemsworth and Tom Hiddleston.
The only thing I'd seen Chris Hemsworth in was he was James Kirk's dad.
Yeah, he had like a brief scene in Star Trek.
And he was awesome in it. He was really good, but he wasn't like this like jacked God of Thunder.
Was Tom Hiddleston somebody before?
He actually was Kenneth Branagh's first choice to play Thor. And like there's a thing of him like auditioning for Thor. Blonde hair and everything. Like he bleached it. Huh. Or probably was wearing a wig now that I think about it.
When did Cabin in the Woods come out?
After
Thor?
After
Thor.
Well, here, let me.
It's not super.
It's not that important. It was after Thor, though. So he was already Thor, man. But now, the journey of Thor, think about it all the way to Ragnarok. Like, Thor 1 was okay. Thor 2 was not good.
Oh, see, I liked Thor 1 quite a bit.
I did enjoy Thor 1.
I didn't finish Thor 2.
It's not good.
Yeah.
No, it was on yesterday. It was on yesterday. I'm like, oh, I haven't seen this in a while. I'm like, oh, this is really bad.
It's not bad. Like there really isn't a bad, like awful Marvel movie, but there's some that are super good. So why waste your time?
Matt Friels has been trying to get me to watch it. And I told him, I was like, nah, it's just not good. And he's like, I'm going to loan it to you. And I was like, really? You don't have to. And so he brings me the DVD. Like,
did you just throw it in the trash?
No, I'm just like, I don't have like a hard time finding the movie. I don't want to watch it.
Oh, here. So let me make this easy. This is not the problem. Yeah. I don't want to watch it.
You're missing the point. But I will watch it because he's insistent. Like, give it another try. He's like, I didn't like it the first time either. Give it another try.
I did. Yeah. I tried to give it a try yesterday. like literally yesterday. I was watching it. Like, oh, no. The Dark Elves are, you know what it is? And it's funny too, because I love Natalie Portman.
Exactly.
I love her. Yeah. Everything she's been, she's in Annihilation.
She's great in everything.
She's incredible. She's one of our generation's best actors.
We should have done an episode that had, just we should that, do an episode that has.
She's in a lot of our movies too, a lot of our episodes. I hate her in the Thor movies. She's terrible in them. The character's not good, and it's not her fault.
Yeah.
It's like, it just doesn't make much sense. Anyway, it doesn't matter. This is Thor Watch 2019.
Since you brought up, this is all stemmed from Jim Carrey, the pole.
Being handsome.
Yeah. So Jim Carrey's going to be coming out in a new movie. Have you guys seen the trailer this week?
The Sonic movie.
So the Sonic controversy, have you guys heard about it? It's got like, the internet is like in an uproar over him.
Not anymore.
I know, that's the funny thing.
Not anymore.
And I'm pissed that he caved.
No, I'm not. I think that's amazing.
No, because that just means that like all people have to do is just gripe enough, and then they're just going to change whatever it is. I think that it looks pretty interesting. So the background
looks horrible.
The Sonic trailer came out, and Sonic looks unsettling.
It's hard to look at. It's hard to watch.
He's got those weird human legs, and he's like doing that like jump, like getting ready to run.
He's got a full torso.
He's got a full
torso,
like, human kid torso, and then this giant head. But the face is just
teeth.
It's that uncanny valley thing where it's like it's a little too human, and I think we expect it to look a little more cartoony.
Yes.
But I kind of liked it. I think it's funny.
You liked it because you're a contrarian.
No, I liked it before that. And then I heard about
it. I liked it before. It was cool.
Yeah.
I worship the old gods. You might not have heard of them.
I never played Sonic, so I like care. Literally do not
but
care.
People are in
Sega!
Uproar. People are in an uproar because like this is our creature that it has to be perfect, and they want it to be perfect. So I was watching a video this morning, though. But yeah, Jim Carrey's going to play Dr. Robotnik.
Which is nice to see him on screen.
So I was telling my wife this morning.
My wife.
I was in bed naked with my wife.
Yeah, of course. We haven't had that in a long time. That's great. Good for you, man.
I was asking her if she'd heard about the Sonic movie, because she loved Sonic when she was a kid.
Sonic.
She played it a lot. Have you heard about the Sonic?
They have free shakes after 8 p.m.
And so I asked her if she'd seen the trailer, and she hadn't. And so I was telling her about the whole controversy. We watched it. And so, like, she had this huge smile when, like, the sounds came up, like the Sega sound and the little ring sound. And she saw Sonic. And then, like, when Jim Carrey stepped on the scene, she's like, I want to see this movie.
Yeah. I'll take the girls. She was just, for like, sure. Yeah. I was going to take the girls no matter what. Because Dan Hill actually pointed out, he'd said,
I read his Facebook post.
He's like, it's a kid movie, guys.
It's a movie for kids.
It's a movie for kids. Stop.
Calm the fuck down.
Yeah.
But it's all these old school fanboys that, like, they feel a sense of ownership, and this is their character, and you can't ruin it.
Isn't Sonic, like, the number one topic for, like, fanfic porn, like, on the internet?
He's like,
because he's very furry.
He's always pregnant with, like, Shrek's baby.
Yeah.
And but you guys have to go out and see some of the things, because everybody's making fun of it. Yeah. So they're doing all these mock-ups and stuff. And, like,
they're amazing.
They took, like, pictures of the little boy in Jumanji when he turns into, like, the werewolf.
Yes.
They made him blue.
Monkey.
He turns into a monkey. And then they took, like, and they're like, oh, the sequel, and it's Tails, but it's like this grotesque looking like thing.
I've seen so many.
You have to go look at all the funny memes. It's hilarious.
So there's something to be said, though, too, because I don't. Okay. Toxic fandom is a real problem that we have, especially right after The Last Jedi came out.
Solo.
A Solo came out. Like, those are all incredibly.
You said A Solo?
A Solo. The Solo?
Yeah, The Solo.
When the Solo came out with the Sonic.
Solo was fun. It didn't. It wasn't on par with Rogue One or anything.
No,
we've had this conversation before.
Yeah, nothing's going to be.
But,
no.
I mean,
except
it didn't,
for Rogue One 2.
It didn't deserve the vitriol.
Rogue One 2, they live.
Well, we talked about Disney Plus. They're going to have
zombies. The zombies come back and fight Darth Vader.
It's really crazy, man. Disney Plus is going to have a Cassian and K2SO show.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
I'm super excited for that.
Okay, I was already going to subscribe. Yeah. Now I'm going to subscribe twice.
Well, because Mandalorian's on day one.
Yeah.
And I'm really excited. That has the cast for The Mandalorian
with,
is ridiculous.
Pedro Pascal, right?
On air.
And the Zek.
Yeah.
I know, we talked about it last year.
No, no, no.
Last week.
On air, I was vocally against
this
the whole.
Feels
the,
like last year.
The Disney Plus app.
Like, it was last year.
Yeah, it was a few months ago, I think. We talked about it. And I was like against it because I don't
it
like the idea.
It was literally 3 weeks ago.
No. I think that was the second time we talked about it. Okay, I think we talked about it some months before.
You're right.
And I was saying that I didn't like it because now what's going to happen is we're going to get back into sort of like the cable yoke, because you're going to have Netflix, you're going to have that Hulu,
absolutely.
You're going to have
that
Amazon.
I do agree with you.
And everyone's going to come out with their own app, and they're going to take all their content and move it away. Mm-hmm. So I was like, I'm kind of against it. But, like, God, they're making some good moves. Like,
why would you
need
anything besides Disney Plus? Like, legit. Why would you need anything else besides Disney Plus?
Well, if you want network shows, you got to have Hulu.
But like, who wants networks?
I might drop Netflix if I switch over to Disney. I don't know.
I mean, right now, the big tech four are Google, Apple, Amazon, and Facebook. Once Disney buys them all, we'll have our NBN. We'll have
Is Facebook in there? I would probably replace Facebook with Apple. Well, not Apple, with
they. Well,
Disney.
I mean,
did you say Disney?
No, he's putting Disney on a tier above them.
Okay, I'm saying Disney buys the big four, then that's all we need.
I'm so excited.
Shouldn't there be some like antitrust like sessions with Congress or something soon?
Sure. In theory, but that's not
when they
happen.
Screw up. Yes, but they have not yet to screw up. I welcome the day when Disney takes over the world. It's gonna be a small world.
I think he's sitting in office. He's just got a business suit on.
I think we already passed the point of no return.
I collected all the Infinity Stones.
All the power.
Megacorps are here. Like any chance to make that not happen has
so just like
come and gone.
Just go with it. No, I see what you're saying.
Pretty soon, the U.S. government will be a subsidiary of Disney.
Yeah.
Yes, and that sounds amazing.
United States of America, a division of Disney.
No, TM. So there's a Cassian Andor. They're going to have Rebels, of course, is going to be on there. I can't wait.
Yeah.
Because I didn't finish Rebels.
I didn't either.
Because I didn't have Disney XD. So now I'm going to have Disney Plus. I'm going to be able to watch The Fox and the Hound.
Yeah.
I'm really wondering, though, if they're going to have gargoyles on there. If they have gargoyles, oh my gosh, gargoyles on there. If they have Chippendale's Rescue Ranger, Darkwing Duck.
Darkwing Duck.
Let's get dangerous. So good, man.
When there's trouble, you call DW.
DW, that's right.
I hope they need to do like Disney after hours. Like, I want a Darkwing Duck that is like fucking gritty.
Oh yeah, like a
and
like
brutal,
like a detective, like noir kind of like.
Yeah,
he's just in a trench coat and it's raining. Right. He shoots.
He
a man
still
in
has
alley.
His list. Like, he still has his list.
Yeah,
let's go.
Oh yeah, don't change any of that. But like hyper
like a
gritty
live action, but like you know how Howard the mm-hmm. Duck was, where so it's like puppeteers and puppets and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Live action Darkwing Duck, that'd be tight.
But like super violent and
yeah,
their weird screw.
Yeah, he like
screwy penises.
I want Game of
He's an
Duck.
Alcoholic and like he sleeps with a hooker. Like all kinds of like just really dark
yeah.
stuff.
Yeah.
Let's get dangerous. Yeah. Hurts my mouth to lisp because I've worked so hard to get rid of it.
Emphasis on dark.
Dark wing duck. You like dark meat? The duck breath start to lift it. I don't know, whatever. Do you guys like duck?
I've never been a huge fan. I think I maybe had it once, and I don't remember liking it.
Really?
It's very greasy. It's like a slimy kind of meat, right?
Billy's, which I know you guys don't like Billy's, they do an almond duck. That's killer. It's so good. I'm a fan. Yeah. I'm a fan, yeah. Have you guys seen, I just wanted to make sure this got pointed out, the Nathan W. Pyle Strange Planet?
Yeah, I love that.
It's incredible, yeah. Right?
Don't know what it is.
You've seen it probably like in passing. It's
on
aliens
a lot.
It's on. It's their little like blue
their take on like Earth stuff.
I'll send you a whole bunch of screenshots
like a,
of it.
Like a comic,
literally, it's a 4-panel comic strip.
Yeah.
So nice. Like it really,
I've
really
seen it. Yeah, on
you will. Anyway, Hometers, if you have not done Nathan W. Pyle's Strange Planet, I'll message you a whole bunch of them in a minute and you'll laugh at all of them. Yeah. Basically what it is, it's like aliens doing our customs and how strange they are if you put them. Donnie's coming over.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
All right. Here we go. First panel. I found this and it's an alien holding a cat.
Yes.
And his friend sitting at a table with a glass of
gripping
water.
Gripping
radio. Yeah. And then the next panel says, it's vibrating. And the other one at the seat says, that means it's working. So then third panel.
Yeah.
The one sitting down says, what does it excel at? And the other alien standing with the cat says, he's scratching. He's got like, he's holding up his arm. He's got scratches on his arm. And then he says, also hiding. And then the one sitting down says, an ideal companion.
It's really good. There's one about fire. I'm going to read another one. It's they're sitting by a fireplace, a fire, like a fire pit.
And you go, another one?
Yeah. And he says, I have procured a primitive heat source. And then, like, anyway, I love the scent. Congratulations. It is now your scent, too. I'm going to blow into this metal box. Ah, how quaint. And he says, who wants to stab sweet pillows? Marshmallows. Anyway, we obviously, from us reading the panels to you, you're just gripped.
Right.
Like, you're you are
already
on
like, you've stopped
board.
This show, and you're now subscribing to that comic.
But, like, I almost every home tree that I've interacted with, like, I think it was Justine in Santiago that turned me on to him. But, like, Paul Chomo from Barman's, like, he's super into him. Like, and he just came out with, like, an actual, like, book compilation of all of them. It's like, I might actually buy that
good
comic book.
I want that guy to make money.
Yeah, I wanted to make all the money. I might, now he's making shirts. And I want a shirt from it. Anyway, it's just all really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, I don't like the word grok. Do you guys know this word?
Yeah.
It's a Heinlein thing.
It's like a beatnik thing.
It's like you understand it.
Like comprehend. Do you grok what my mouth music is saying?
Yeah. It's have you heard this word before?
First time I've heard this.
I've
grokked this before.
It just means understand on a deep level. Basically, like on an intrinsic level, but like so it has a it comes from a Heinlein novel. I forget which one it was, but like Strange Planet or something. But people have been using it, and it drives me insane when people.
I don't want that word to come back.
I don't want that word to be around. And, oh, I grok that. Like no. Just say understand. Please say I understand that. Like you're not like because now you're gonna have to explain it to people. Anyway, if you use the word grok, stop it. That's it. Also, a friend of mine was saying that like he has these coworkers now are saying, may you please. May you please.
May you please. That's not.
That's not good.
That's not right.
That's not right at all. No. And so he said one was using it. And I'm like, okay, is this a thing now that like I don't know about? You say, may you please.
Yeah.
And then a second coworker started saying it.
Yeah.
I would kill myself.
That sounds like, I honestly sounds like in my household, I've been trying to teach my kids as they grow up to say, you know, may I have seconds or may I have a cookie or something like that.
Yeah.
As opposed to, can I?
Yeah.
Right.
What's the BioShock?
Can you please?
Oh,
yeah.
It's not can you please.
Would you kindly? Yeah. And so that was mine. It's like, oh, maybe they're trying to do, would you? It's like, no, that's nothing. May you please.
So what I was saying is like my kids, they didn't quite understand it. So like they would use it in other situations. Like, right. You know, may you hand me a glass? I'm like, no, you don't have to do it that way. You can actually say like, can you hand me a glass in that situation? It's only when you're asking permission for something. Yeah. But it just sounds like the conversations I'm having with my kids. Yeah. Like
these are grown adults.
Yeah. Just teach them the imperative. It's not, may you hand me a glass? Or can you hand me a glass? It's hand me a glass.
Cut out
hand
the
me
middle
a glass and add bitch at the end.
Cut out the middleman there on that one. It's similar to like when somebody doesn't. It's like if someone doesn't know like certain rules, and so they're just like, okay, whom?
Yeah, exactly right. They find a big word and they want to use it. Yeah. And sound smart, but they're not using it properly.
Yeah, I grok that. I hate it.
If we're going to bring back a stupid word that means comprehend or understand, let's do savvy.
Ooh, savvy's a good one. You savvy?
Savvy?
I'm 100% in on that.
I'd rather hear that than grok.
Savvy. I hear you.
What is grok derived from?
From a Highland novel. Like where he says it's supposed.
Oh, so it's a future word he made up.
It's a future word he made up. Okay. And then it's to understand something on like a level that isn't taught. Mm-hmm. Like you just know it because you know it.
Yeah. I mean,
yeah, most exactly.
I was going to say like, I guess I have a little bit of a problem with writers making up words, but then I think about like Shakespeare wrote half of our modern language. Most of the words that we use are things that he made up.
I don't mind it when people make up words. All words are made up.
To quote Thor, yeah. all words are made up.
Yeah. Yeah, all words are made up. Like they are, but like, yeah. And there's certain ones like, nah, man, you don't get to do that.
Yeah, it's like, you got to try.
And what's it for
public
Key
opinion
Peele?
is going to weigh. What?
It's pussy off the chain wax. Do you guys remember that?
No, I never saw
that. It's like Key and Peele. I hate even saying it, but like, he's, oh man, that pussy was off the chain wax. And like the friend looks at him, bro, that's a thing. Like
it is now.
It is now. Like you can't just invent something that horrible.
There was a Mad TV skit back in like the 90s. And it was like the black culture people were like sitting around coming up with the next big thing. And like, it was all that in a bag of chips. And like, no, we already did that. That's
I think I know where you're going.
That's Ebola.
Yes. Girl, her booty is Ebola. She got an Ebola booty.
Really?
Yeah. We need to get this out to the white suburbans.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
It's because it was like a devastating thing. Like, so you wanted to have like a big impact. So like, yeah, Ebola was the new cool
Ebola.
Word.
Ebola.
But yeah, there was this secret council of like urban slang.
Yeah. Once you started that, I was like, I know where he's going. Yeah.
Oh man, it's so good. Have you guys heard of Lil Nas X? Do you guys know who this is?
No.
So I read an article. It said the future of country music. Will they accept him? And so so like the future of country music is a rapper. And so then like I went and listened to the song, like two genres that I'm not a very big fan of. Like yeah. There are songs in both genres that I'm fine with, country and rap.
Do two wrongs make a right in the situation?
So I went in there fully expecting to completely hate this song.
And it made a right.
And man, it's good stuff, bro. It is my jam right now. And like, yeah. We've just been bumping it. It's clean. It's like a minute and 50 seconds long.
Yeah.
He has one song, quote unquote, future of country music is this 1 minute and 52 seconds
song. That doesn't make sense though, because country music is like rock 20 years ago. So the future of country music is like Breaking Benjamin.
Oh yeah. Is that that one that Clancy Brown says?
Yeah.
FT, Clancy Brown. I always kind of want you to put it on right now from YouTube. To listen to it, see what you guys think.
All right.
Yeah, you guys don't have to like it. You like Elise didn't like it. She says like, oh, this kind of sounds like a joke song. Like it's good.
Do anything.
You don't have to do anything.
Exactly. Don't tell me what to do. Yeah. Now I'm gonna like it because you're
talking. You don't have to. I'm trying to explain to you that like
this is my favorite fucking song, Chris.
I haven't heard it yet. I love it.
No, but that's the thing is, I want you guys to understand that like my ego is not dependent on whether you guys like this song. Like you can like it or not like it. I just was like interested in it and I ended up like going into it not wanting to like it and then I totally dug it.
I'm sure it'll be all right. On YouTube. I'm about to play it. Yeah. But I'm at 0 seconds and the first panel on the visuals is like, is this from Red Dead Redemption 2? Is it did they make a video from Red Dead Redemption?
Probably.
Because like
I have it on Spotify.
He's a cowboy and he's got like a bandana over his face, but like his nose and lips are clipping through it. So
oh, I love that. Yeah, what? That's not part of the song. Yeah, good radio.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached.
I don't think this is country. I think this is
not,
just...
It is 100% not
just
country.
Just cowboy-themed rap.
Yep, yeah. Exactly.
Chris is just like pumping his fist as you're into it.
Oh, I'm white. I'm so white.
Riding on a tractor, lean all in
tractor.
My butt. Yep. Cheated on my baby. You can go and ask.
Did they pay royalties on this? Yes. Oh, no, we're critiquing. Critique.
Yeah. Fair use. Ranger on my
booty. I'll just keep playing in the background, but.
Yeah, that's a rap song that has a country like tinge to it.
Exactly. Yeah.
Gangsta Grass is more like future of rap country. No, they're like a bluegrass hip hop band.
Ooh. Please play something from them.
From Gangsta Grass.
We have. Right. Oh, by the way, Hometers, we have no voicemails.
Gangsta Grass, it's like Long Hard Road or something like that.
So this one's called Old Town Road. What about roads? Roads.
Long Hard Road?
Something like that's.
Ain't nobody tell me nothing. Come on. It's good. So the
it's
remix.
From Justified.
It was the theme, yeah.
So, okay. So the remix features Billy Ray Cyrus singing that first part.
That is Game of Thrones.
This is Game of Thrones.
Yeah, that's not. That's not Gangsta Grass.
All right, here we go.
Can you see him in banjo right now? Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah. I'm 100% in. To this. Play it later.
Yeah, this is more country rap to me. I love me some bluegrass.
So we've been. So I'm gonna buy a mandolin.
Yeah.
Because I was watching a Steve Martin video. You know, he's an incredible banjo player. Uh-huh. And so he has his band that he plays with. And then I was looking at the man, and I always love doing getting new instruments and trying. I know you do the same. So I'm looking at the mandolin, like I'm looking like this is like the easiest instrument in the world to play. Like I'm super in, and I don't know where the mandolin came from. Anyway, I just want a mandolin now. That's it. But so we've just been so on my Spotify, I keep this playlist called Indie Bluegrass on, and so it's not twangy. It's like real human beings singing. Not like this. Anyway, it's so good. Such talent. What's the song called again?
This is It's Long Hard Times to Come, the main theme for Justified.
Yeah, so Justified was how I heard of these guys. I've since bought some of their albums. They've got an album called Rapalachia.
Yes.
And I don't remember what the other... I've got two of their albums, and like after hearing them on that theme song, like I got to know more about these guys.
This is a side. I'll probably cut this, but I was driving for Uber last night.
You're not gonna cut anything. I'm just messing with you.
And I was driving for Uber, so I picked up a guy, this white dude, and he was
okay. Why does he got to be white?
Because he's a rapper.
Oh, okay.
It's relevant.
Oh, okay.
Dope, right rapper. Okay. Anyway, we just got to talking, and we were talking about Crab Radio, and they don't play because they were playing like some EDM song.
Yeah.
And he's like, "Oh, EDM, huh?" And I was like, "Yeah, this is whatever's on Crab." And he was just like, "You know, we're talking about how it's not rock anymore."
No,
yeah.
It's not.
And so he started talking about his favorite genre. You know, is more rap. And he's like, "I'm a battle rapper." And then
what's his name?
His name is Rarick, R A R I C.
Like that's his rap name or that's his actual name?
He said it's his last name, but he's a battle rapper here from Bakersfield. And so I asked him, you know, what's your YouTube so I can go check it out. It's pretty good. But in the car while I'm driving him, he starts doing this rap that he wrote about Slipknot. It was super clever. He was referencing like Duality and Volume 3, all kinds of stuff, subliminal verses, like. It's really clever. I was like, damn, this kid's good. He might be going somewhere.
There's one thing. That's cool.
Yeah.
A cool story, bro. But also.
No, but it was like.
No, but like.
You experience some funny things when you're driving for Uber. Like,
absolutely.
You meet some cool people.
That's also like super douchey. Just like. Could you imagine someone just started kind of like singing in the back? Oh, here's my song. Let me sing for you.
You know what? You gotta hustle though. You wanna make it?
You
gotta
hustle. Like, hey, I'm a podcaster.
Who knows?
Let me hold up. Let me do some bits for my podcast.
This is his big break. He rapped to me as an Uber driver in his car.
Okay.
I told him I had a podcast.
Yes.
I'm now talking about him on my podcast. Somebody out there listens to this.
Spell it.
R-A-R-I-C.
Gotcha.
Rarick on YouTube.
Got it.
Somebody listens to it, goes and finds him, and now he becomes a millionaire.
That's it.
Bro, maybe.
A chameleonaire?
Bro, I'm not going to tip you, but I'm going to drop some fire on you.
Exactly.
I'm going to drop some bars on
you. So, I don't have monetary funds, but I am,
he was a tipper,
I am an artiste. I am an artiste, and so let me play for you, my new patron. And then, like...
No, it was pretty good, though.
Gonna drive my horse to the old town road.
Slipknot, the band?
Yeah, he was, because we were talking
it's
about...
It's Clancy Brown's second
just,
band.
He was just saying that, yeah. Like, Breaking Benjamin was in Slipknot, you know, early in the early days.
Yeah. We all know this.
Somebody in the back. They're managed. At this point, though, they were managed by Clancy Brown.
Slipknot does have like 13 people in it. So like it could have been multiple
don't
bands.
Don't they wear masks? So yeah, one of them very well could have been Clancy Brown.
One could have been Clancy Brown.
It could have been anybody at some point. I know, right? Oh, you know what? It's true. We don't know that Clancy Brown was not in
exactly.
Slipknot.
That's prove all it. I know about Slipknot.
Who wasn't?
Prove it.
Didn't they wear masks?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't dislike Slipknot. I like the song Vermillion Part 2. That's a really good song.
Do you now?
I do. Yeah. I don't know what. I think I had it on a playlist where we went to see Taz.
Yeah.
It's a great song.
Yeah.
The bass line is really cool.
Yeah.
I used to play it. Like, it was one of the, because like when you play bass, like you're like, okay, yeah, I can just do, you know, or whatever. But like to like push yourself, I got to like learn all these different ones so I could actually like be a bass player.
Yeah.
Geezer Butler, that shit.
What? What's that?
Geezer Butler. The best. Your face. The greatest bass player ever.
I don't know who that is.
No, the original bass player.
He's not the greatest bass player.
For Black Sabbath.
Nobody knows of him.
Oh, okay.
But I mean, he like fills and like he was a part of the band. He wasn't just some dude in the background.
But like more so than Cliff Burton or Justin Chancellor
or Flea. Yes. I would say those guys probably worship Geezer Butler.
Nance Corner?
Support yourself a nice glass of sarsaparilla. Sit in a rocking chair. Cuddle up with a nice blanket. Because it's time for Nance Corner.
Nan hasn't been super busy on the Instas. She just got back from Oregon.
Yeah.
That looked cool. Did Melly go with her?
Yeah.
It looked like it. That's fun. I forget that you have siblings. Sibling.
Sibling.
Sibling. Yeah. That also has
a sibling.
Yeah. A sibling.
The sibling.
Yeah. And then his secret sibling, Clancy Brown.
Yeah.
But we lost Peter Mayhew. This week, Chewbacca.
Yeah.
And so I posted a picture of him hugging Princess Leia, Carrie Fisher, who have now also passed on. Thing is, folks, get ready for that because they're all old.
Yeah.
And like that's coming.
Yeah.
Like Harrison Ford is creeping up there. Ugh. Anyway.
Everybody's got to go eventually.
Eventually. I don't, Mr. Stark, I don't want to go. It's Infinity War. Spoiler.
I saw that one.
Yeah, you saw that one. Yeah. But your mom, Banan says, Vaya con Dios for Chewbacca. And that was Nan's Corner. That was a bummer. It's because like, luckily Chewbacca can continue to be there.
You can always have a C-3PO. You can always have an R2-D2.
You can always have them and everything. Which today we are recording on May the 4th. So
be with you. It is Star Wars Day.
Yeah. When we were watching New Hope when you came in, I got my Star Wars mug. Yeah. Got my Star Wars mug in my hand. I'm a rapper now.
Yeah.
I'm coming for you, Rarick. I had a friend, it was Chris Smith. He called himself Mac Jack. Mackerel Jack was his rap name.
Really?
And this was in high school.
Mac Miller is a white rapper.
Oh, really? It's not him. He's dead.
Mac Miller died. Yeah. But I'm just saying.
It's not him.
Yeah. It's just funny how like a lot of the names just kind of get reused.
And the thing is, I would have said, hey, Mac Miller, I went to high school with him and now he's dead. That would have been a conversation.
Yeah.
Mackerel Jack, I have no idea where he is right now. He was super talented. But at Stockdale, where I went to high school, the whitest school in Bakersfield, they would at lunchtime. I talked about this when we had Kinetic Distortion on.
Yeah.
They would have rap battles.
Mm-hmm. And you'd break dance, right?
And I would break dance. Definitely not that.
You had your full Adidas jumpsuit on.
And carried around cardboard.
And my cardboard. Yeah, there you go.
and a bicycle helmet. So you could do your head spin.
No, man, just a beanie. But there would be rap battles at lunchtime. Yeah. And they would do it. And Chris, his name was Chris, Mac Jack would slay, except for there was this one guy, Evan Mother freaking Chambers. I hated this guy. He would write like quotes on his shirt, like his white t-shirt. Yeah. And like he created his own little gang called like the Rowdy Rough Riders or something like that. And like they had like a slogan or whatever.
Born leader, huh?
Oh, and he was the
charismatic
gay.
No, when I say gay, it was him by himself.
Oh, okay.
And this is like his gang.
Can you be gay with yourself?
Gang. Like,
what do you mean? Gang.
Gang.
No, I said gay.
Yeah, Donnie said gay. Okay.
Okay, I said gay.
You Rowdy Rough Riders? Come on.
He's a power bottom.
If you really think about it, every time you masturbate, you're gay with yourself.
Exactly. Yeah. That's what I was going to say. Because you said it was just by himself. Yeah. I was like, no, does that make like, you gay?
He had like one friend and they called himself, oh, we're the Rowdy Rough Riders. And he's like, two of us. And the shirt, and he had like a shirt that he wrote in Sharpie that was like, two of us are going to enter into this thing.
That's
and
the kind of guy who shoots up the school later.
Yeah, absolutely. So he would write down rap lyrics ahead of time, memorize it, and pretend that he was doing a rap battle. And so he would win, and they would have like, but everyone knew that he was writing his own because he's not clever. He would like write things down. Like,
that's not freestyling.
That's not freestyling.
But I think that is part of freestyling. Honestly, I think that you work out certain bars, and then to succeed at the freestyle, you have to include your opponent and things that happen.
He would always go
but
first.
But you can plug in words that you've already sort of pre-programmed. You have like modules that you can plug together.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
No, this guy was a douchebag. He would always go first. And so then, okay. So then Mac Jack.
But I'm saying where his diss is specific to the person standing in front of him. And that he didn't have it pre-learned.
Yeah.
The point is you pre-learned. Have to. I'm trying to think of words.
Don't defend Evan Chambers.
May I?
Yeah. May you please stop defending Evan Chambers. I don't gronk that. Yeah, I don't gronk. See, if you said that you gronked it, that's a verb that I'm super. Hey, Star Wars Day. No, if you gronk something, that's definitely a verb that I ascribe to.
But yeah, so you're right. Like, this guy was not actually freestyling.
No, no, he would always go first. They were non-specific and everyone knew it, but he liked to play I don't write these. Yeah. Like, yes, bro, we know you are writing this ahead of time.
I'm actually going to share a video that I watched of Rarick's rap battle with this black dude on the, they were like in an apartment complex or something like that.
Really?
It's actually really good.
What's their address?
Like, it's funny because like when they first start off, like it's a little rough, but then they just start getting this flow and they go for a long time. Like,
that's cool.
Each of their raps are like 6 minutes, 7 minutes each.
Hey, let's watch 8 Mile. Let's watch 8 Mile. You know what?
These are actually better than 8 Mile, and they're like very charismatic when they're doing it, and like you know, just doing a lot of like gestures and stuff. It's very interesting.
Oh,
to
you
watch.
Get it. There's an energy.
Yeah,
for sure.
It's definitely the energy and how they deliver everything. And it's impressive. Like I said, each of them kind of starts off a little weak and like, okay, you're struggling a little bit. This could be disastrous.
And you're
then
gonna get
boom,
this.
They just like get to this flow and then
you're gonna get it.
Then that I think they make up for like their errors in the beginning by just going long and just keep coming up with stuff. But it's pretty clever. It was a fun battle.
It's normal to be nervous at first. Palms are sweaty.
Yeah.
Mom spaghetti.
Anyway, the point is. We all hope that Evan Chambers is lying in a ditch right now.
F you, Evan Chambers.
He's still writing on his shirt.
He played football with me too. I'm just going to bring. We're just going to keep going with this.
Evan's
so he was a year younger than me in high school, and he played football. And he acted like he was. He always walk around like with his jersey. He had like a Letterman jacket. The dude was like fifth string at best.
Crying out for attention.
Like
clearly
fifth string at best, and was like. I think like they let him play like one special team group or whatever. And like he would wear like he would tape up his wrists and like have tape all over his fingers and like have all this like gear. Like he's going to go out there. He had like a cowboy collar. You know what a cowboy collar is? Where like it was like to keep your head from going back too far because you hit too hard when you tackle. Dude didn't play. So anyway.
Well, there's 23 seconds to go and we're up by 47 points. Chambers, you're in.
Yes, that is correct. So anyway, I remember because my brother is 2 years younger than me. And so like my brother played. He was a tight end. He was really good. And so Evan, like his senior year, like there was a chance that he might be able to like play more than just one down a game. Anyway, he shatters his leg. No.
We shouldn't be laughing about that.
No, he shatters his leg. It like doing, I kid you not, filming like a Jackass style stunt. Like shatters it into a million places. Like he's going to be crippled for his entire life. And I remember
that's how he ended up in that ditch today.
And so anyway, I was thinking like, and my first thought.
It's just like, I sit it in sideways. You can't get out. Help, I have a high school injury. I've never been able to walk since. Help me out of this ditch.
Oh my gosh. Here's the thing.
This shirt just has an inspirational quote.
Well, now he's got like.
It's something from like Game of Thrones. Yeah. I'll never walk again, but someday I'll fly or something.
Yeah, now he's got like brand quotes on.
No, I think last time I saw him,
Keep on rolling.
But like,
he's got a three-eyed raven tat.
So he would somehow, he was the one that was in charge. He somehow became the music person for the weight room there too, for like all the sports.
Is this the guy that played nothing but System of a Down?
Yes! Yes, it was this douchebag.
Good memory, dude.
Yes, good job.
No, I listen to Chris sometimes.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I was so excited that he remembered something I said. And, wake up! Why don't you put it all up again? Like, no one liked this song. Like, what are you doing? But like, he was like, I'm hardcore. I'm so hardcore. Anyway,
shattered leg.
Shatters his leg into a million pieces. Still got to participate in team activities. It actually was, thinking about it, like, one at first, I'm like, good. I hate this guy. I'm glad you're crippled.
I hope he is a home tree. I hope he was back through all of his high school friends on Facebook. He found Chris Brayton, like, oh, he's got a podcast. I'm going to listen to it. And he's a home tree.
Yeah.
Chambers, call the hotline.
Yeah, call the hotline. Call. Please call. Last time I checked, he was a bouncer at Sandrini's. That was the last time I saw him, which is like, no, why are you a bouncer? Like, I know for a fact, like, my daughters could beat you up.
And now
he got like a...
Now I know where to go if I want to...
He's like replaced with like a...
Now I know where I'm going tonight.
If I want to start some shit, I'm going to Sandrini's.
Yeah. Don't, because some of the other bouncers are rather large.
Does Lou do Sandrini's?
No, I don't think he does.
I don't want to...
Is Lou a big dude, you guys know?
Yeah, he works for the secret
government. Yeah, oh, you almost slipped up!
I didn't. I knew what I was going
to say. Anyway, so what ended up happening is he got to go to every game with just his jersey. Didn't have to practice, but he got to hang out. And he got to like, hey, guys, if I could be out there, I would. And I was like, oh, my gosh, this is your dream right now. You get to be like the martyr.
Yeah.
That gets you get all the good things. Anyway, I hate that guy. He was just the worst. Also, so
which of your girlfriends did Evan Chambers steal?
Neither.
You hate this dude
so
much.
No. He was like racist, homophobic too. Like, this guy was a bad person. Like, he's like, he's a bad, bad human being. Yeah. I remember one time my girlfriend in high school, when I broke up with her, like, he really liked her, and like, she was bummed. Like, it was not a good thing. Like, breaking up is never happy. Anyway, him and his friends, like, hey, do you want us to go beat up Chris for you for breaking up with you? Because he knew her too. And she's like, oh, no, it's okay. It's like, I wish that he had tried to beat
come
me
at
up.
Me, bro.
Should have called him and said, no, go take him up on that.
Please, like, hey.
Send him.
Hey, I know that we just.
You send him to me.
Please, if you, we will get back together. Please just send him. I want to murder this fool. Anyway. Evan, I hope you're in a good place. You know,
good ditch
with your.
Some ditches are better than others.
Absolutely, like if you
I'm
think
just
about,
saying,
like what is a canal? You know, a beautiful in San Antonio, the beautiful canals of San Antonio, but a water filled.
How about the beautiful Venice?
Exactly.
The beautiful ditches of Venice.
We've been talking about places to go this summer. And like San Antonio would come up because they had that cool like canal system going through it.
Bakersfield was going to have one of
those. Remember that?
Well, we lived out there. So like they were digging all those fields up that we used to always go out into. And stuff like that.
Yeah.
Are you going to go like tour the Pace factory?
Is that?
In San Antonio.
San Antonio. Yeah. New York City.
Get a rope. It's good then.
More Gooder Than is proud to be sponsored by Range Outdoors. Range provides high quality and stylish apparel for people who want to, as they put it, go be free. They are a group of fishermen, climbers, backpackers, hunters, mountain bikers, and outdoor enthusiasts that want to help conserve and protect the environment they love for our future generations. They give their time and donate a portion of proceeds to conservation efforts. Head to range-outdoors.myshopify.com to check out their entire catalog.
So MGT Light, so we have some pretty terrible news actually to bring up right now. Dave Morgan is no longer a seventh tier patron. So what? He dropped down to third tier.
What?
Yeah. Dave.
I'm insulted.
He's no longer a sponsor of the show.
You know what?
I
quit.
Yeah. So
I needed that $45 for some teeth.
For some teeth.
Not my teeth are fine, but I needed some teeth for other things.
No! What did you do? Good. You broke the thing.
Good Foley.
He's storming up. Anyway, because of that, And only because of that.
Specifically
that because Dave changed his thing. We actually have decided to end More Gooder Than. Specifically because Dave changed his patron.
Not because you're leaving for the summer and it's been 3 years and we kind of want to move on to other things. Yeah, it's all Dave. So anybody who gets pissed off.
Yeah. It's not because
channel
like,
your anger towards Dave.
It's not because Morgan. Like we feel like it's reached a natural closure. It's getting more difficult to find time with our busy families and everything. No, we are ending MGT for serious reasons.
Yeah.
We are specifically ending it because of Dave Morgan. So just
thanks, Dave.
Thanks a lot, Dave. This is the second to last time Corey and I will ever see Chris.
I know we're never going to see each other again.
One more recording session, and that's it.
So like for reals,
yeah.
Dave is the reason. we've been talking about it for
four months or so.
Yeah, about 3 months. And summer's coming up, and summer's so hard for us to record. And we've been doing this for 3 years. Three. Incredible years.
Yeah.
It's
been an absolute blast. I mean, we've made some start incredible to finish. Friends.
Yeah. We've made like global friends.
Global friends. Like we've had the Aussies, they came, they stayed at our house. Dave stayed at our house. Like all our friends, Justin Winters, like everybody, Chris Green has come to our, like we had people come from the world just to visit us.
Yeah.
We can't, like in our next, so that being said, this is the second to last goodie bag.
Penultimate set of episodes, and then we're gonna have
Episode 69, of course, will be the and the Oscar goes to Isaac. Mm-hmm. Episode 70, goodie bag, will be the last goodie bag, and then episode 70, the actual will be our last
TBD.
TBD will be our last main episode. It's crazy to say it, right? This is crazy. Like we've been talking about it for a long time.
Yeah.
So
and every time I walk into this room, I get a little sad. Like, I'm a nostalgic person. So like,
absolutely.
What's been, moving it was on right after Christmas that we were talking about it. So it's been like 5 months.
It's been a while. Episode 62 is when, whatever that was. That's when we brought it up. Hmm. But just know, like we are still like super good. There's nothing like weird or like drama. It's like literally,
We exhausted this idea.
We're just kind of done. And like Donnie, of course,
we accomplished some cool things. Like I think what we set out to do is as three friends,
To put something out there.
Well, this is kind of like a hangout podcast.
Yeah.
We use the movies as like a catalyst for discussion.
Oh, the movies are pointless.
But at the same time, like we all had these movies that we shared, like that Chris and I had seen, but Donnie had never seen.
Yeah,
Donnie and I had seen and Chris had never seen. And so it was an opportunity for us to share some of our favorite pieces of media with each other. And I really think that we've done that.
Absolutely.
I mean, Donnie found some of his new favorite movies. I think you found some of your new favorite movies.
Yeah.
I've been exposed to some new things that are now my favorite things.
I've exposed myself to Corey.
We have accomplished the goal of this project. So I think we've been successful here.
Absolutely.
It was a lot of fun. We met a lot of really cool people. Oh,
man. Think about when we did Bakersfield Comic Con.
Yeah.
The live show at the Bakersfield Escape Room, like people coming in and out of the bunker, all the different guesting we've done. Like we've created.
It's been a blast.
It's been a community that we've.
I never would have reconnected with Thomas without the
absolutely.
Podcast.
Absolutely. I know, right?
Yeah.
We've created some best friends.
For sure.
And one of the biggest things that we realize is that we've been together doing this for 3 years and we don't hate each other.
Yeah.
That's a win. That's a huge win. Like we want to spend more time, but we want to do
Corey
less.
Was just helping you dig holes.
I know, right? Well,
digging up holes. We never did holes on the show.
It's a good movie, man.
It's a great movie.
So anyway, this, we will have this goodie bag, obviously, and then 69, episode 70 goodie bag, and then the actual last finale episode will be episode 70.
Yeah,
so we're not going
three more
away.
Weeks total from this.
Yeah,
from this point forward.
We have, like, obviously, Donnie will still be on Crit Storm with Thomas and Drew and the rest of the crew. I have some ideas to come back in the fall. Maybe, I don't know. Nothing
Pod Fix is still a thing.
Podfix is still a thing. Obviously we will not be part of Podfix because we won't have a show. Mm-hmm. And
you're
actually
still the podfather though, right?
No, I'm going to transfer it over to somebody else.
Okay.
Yeah. So, we'll announce that next week and everything. But it's been great. Yeah, it really has been fun. It feels weird, man. Yeah. But like, obviously,
April's been a little like sad too, because like she had a lot of fun with. She helped out a ton on all of the Victor picks.
Yeah, we've done so many crazy. All the gifts people have sent us.
Yeah,
like this is our. We're not even talking about our Patreon supporters. We're talking like like the Wicklet from Kenny Wong from episode 17.
My hand-drawn sketch of Sloth from
Thomas?
From Merle.
Oh, from Joe. Sorry, from Joe. Merle, yeah, Joe. Just like all the crazy things. Down to the
I got all kinds of big, I got a Big Trouble in Little China comic. Yeah. And like people sent me some Big Trouble stuff.
Like that's all really those awesome. Different things. Plus just the love and the jokes that we've shared.
The fans have been honestly the best.
That's the thing I'm gonna miss.
That's to me like what we've been successful at.
Obviously,
getting a really great fan base.
Oh yeah,
that's the biggest bummer for me. Like I
feel like we're letting them down a little.
Yeah, feeling like we're letting people down.
So you can check out Donnie on Critstorm. Obviously, we've said that, and also we're all available for guesting. This equipment isn't like going to just disappear once we stop. Like all of us still have our mics, so like you can all. Most of the people that we interact with, they have our phone numbers, so they can like, hey, you want to guess? Absolutely, we'll be there. And so like we're still around. There's not even a thing where that none of us are even going to start other podcasts. Like that is not, definitely not out of the realm of possibility. Donnie's still going to be on one, but it's just thank you to everybody.
Yeah,
right. And we'll seriously, do a full thank you list on episode 70 Goodie Bag. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff. So anyway, we love you. And thank you so much. Everything's good.
Except for you.
Freaking Dave Morgan, you destroyed our souls.
Evan Chambers.
Oh, yeah, Evan Chambers.
We don't love Evan Chambers.
I hope you die in a ditch, Evan.
I hope you shattered your wheelchair when you found that ditch.
Your wheelchair broke.
I still love Dave Morgan. Disappointed you ruined the show, but I still
disappointed that he was the catalyst for us ending the show.
I wanted to go on for like another 10 years.
He's gonna text me like, bro, did I really?
I know.
No, because he's the nicest guy. Yeah, he is the nicest guy. But like, I was just thinking about when we had Cody in. Like, what a great freaking episode that was.
Yeah,
it was dangerous. We almost lost our show because people liked him more than us.
I know, it was one of our most downloaded podcast episodes. But even doing the music episodes, writing that one. That we're going to be friends for Who Spiked the Puns.
I can puns tell are that, gonna that puns are going to be spiked.
Puns are going to be spiked. Yeah, right. That was back.
Fun. Did we play it on our show? I know we sent it to them.
I think they played
it on their show. I don't know if we played
it on our
show.
I think we did both.
Show.
I think we put it at the end of the...
The side podcast. Like, I know it didn't get a lot of listens, but man, doing the Three Guys One World Cup with Santiago and Dan was so much fun.
That was awesome.
I did the Lego one with Duty.
Yeah.
Remember that? And then I did the NFL recap show with Chris Green. Mm-hmm. You did so many. You did the dinosaurs. For
I made
Weird
a couple
you.
Songs for some podcasts. Like I love the song that I wrote for you guys' World Cup show. Like I want to take that music and use it for something else because that was such a great piece of music.
And it's just a blast. It's going to be very nice to watch movies just because we feel like watching a movie.
Right?
Yeah, not have it feel like a chore.
And even like just texting you like, well, we're still gonna game. Honestly, I think one of the main reasons we even talked about it too is just
more
like
game time.
I just said like, gosh, I'd really like everything not to be like, I want things to be cash.
Yeah.
I want to go back to like, hey, you want to play a game? No. Hey, that's totally fine. That's okay.
Yeah.
But we'll play another time. Yeah. Anyway, we'll keep going on. We could go on and on and on and on.
I know.
Yeah.
I mean, 3 years, like that's a significant years, part of our life. That's like almost 10% of my life. Been doing this.
Isn't also, your day of your naming day next week?
My name day is on Wednesday.
Yeah.
Are you third
actually today when this comes out, when this is on
third of your name?
Fourth
of your
my
name.
My son is the fifth, yeah.
For, hey, Bridget.
The reason why I paused is for half my life I thought I was the third. My dad told me I was the third. Then he ended up like reconnecting with some family and ended up finding out that his dad was actually named the same thing too. So that made him the third and then I was the fourth.
Oh my
so
gosh.
He ended up telling me when I was a teenager, like, oh, you're not the third, you're the fourth. Okay, cool. Oh, cool.
CJ is the sixth of his name.
Damn.
Is he really?
Yeah.
And CJ, like I would have never known CJ. Right? Like he was just this mystery person that I thought Donnie made up.
Yeah. I've heard about CJ for what, 13 years
Donnie's
now?
Friend that's never around.
Well, like, and now I messaged with CJ just on the reg, just by myself.
He does exist.
Yeah, it's like, oh, cool. He's a cool guy. I like him. He writes things. But like even down to like Mary, her creating our logo and Dan making the home tree logo.
Eternally thankful for those early supporters.
Yeah, eternally grateful. But just like even people that like were there at the beginning and like kind of dropped off because like I stopped listening to shows after a while. But I was a huge fan for... I remember Jason G bringing the thunder, bringing the lightning. Remember that?
Yeah.
It's our first
Tucker Plunkett.
Tucker Plunkett. Like these people that were like listening to the beginning and then like we did something and we lost them.
we offended them in some way. But then you have the ones who've always been with us, like Mother Flippin' Glinda.
Oh, and Sarai.
Andre.
Of course, our wives, obviously. Yeah. You weren't even married when we started the show. Yeah. Donnie? No,
was I not?
No, you weren't. We started. He was married 6 months after we started.
In December of 15.
And we started in July of 2016.
Oh, then I was already married.
Yeah, he was married already. We started in July of 2016.
Did we?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess because this would be our July would be your
third year.
Anyway,
remember our anniversary episode that everyone hated? Gosh.
I'm so glad we're not going to have to do another one. That's so good. But guys, thank you, Donnie and Corey. I've loved every minute of it. Like,
yeah.
We just like, yeah, it's awesome.
Well,
thank
we said
you for being a friend.
We said when we started it that like
down the road and back again.
I'm not singing the
your
Golden
Girls. Your heart is true. You're a pal and a confidant. Boom, 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 boom. And if you threw a party and invited everyone you knew, you would see the biggest gift would be from me. And the
it's
card attached would say, thank you for being a friend.
Dun, 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 no, dun. I'm the Dorothy of this group. I don't go in for that shit. But no, we said when we started, let's do it until it no longer becomes fun. It's still fun.
Still fun.
But it is.
We could see it in the future probably becoming too much of a chore.
Mainly what it was, man, was, and we even said it too, especially for me and Corey, like, man, summer's coming up. We want to do some stuff with our kids. It is like we don't even talk about how many stuff we turned down. To do the show. Like how many times have you not gone somewhere?
Sure.
Absolutely. Not saying that it wasn't worth it, but like now it's like, gosh, our kids are older. Like these are like, now these are like prime time. Donnie's got to like not wear pants as much as he wants to. He's had to put on pants way too much. So, but
not
like,
not a fan.
Who's a fan of pants?
No, I'm super looking forward to getting more game time in. We just started Starfinder. Like,
yeah.
Oh yeah. Did you guys do your thing?
Yeah. It's fun.
It's yeah. Cool. Who's in your group?
Andre, Steve Glindo, Sarai, Josh. Myself.
That's awesome. Yeah. That's so good. That's so fun. Right. That was your guys' like backup game. You wouldn't let me touch the book. Don't touch that.
I didn't.
It was at your house. It was at your house and like the
run a parallel campaign of this same adventure path for the Critstorm crew.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
That's really, really
looking
good.
Forward to that.
So don't worry about like rating and reviewing us anymore. Like I'm not even going to put that in there anymore. that's it. I mean, we got some like, well, episode Goodie Bag 70 is going to be like just nostalgia lane. We're going to like bring up a lot of like, I'm going to have some questionnaires for you guys, cool. But home trees for that. Send in voicemails. Voicemails have definitely tapered off. It's your last chance. Like we don't have any more voicemails. Anyway, for everyone that's listened, just thank you so much for joining us. It's been a blast. Like I almost can't even say that we're an indie podcast anymore because of the community that we've joined and everything. Like it's like, we feel legit, like semi minor celebrities, right? I'm right.
Like I could open a gas station, like, and not like open my own, but I mean, I could like cut the ribbon.
Yeah. But that's going to do it for us, the MGG Recording Bunker, for the third to last time. That's crazy to say.
Yeah.
We really appreciate you rating, reviewing, and subscribing, but don't do that anymore. I have heard that I did some research. We can put it on Anchor, our show, so we don't have to keep paying for Podbean, and it'll keep it going.
Oh, like really? Archive it?
Oh, yeah, cool. Archive it. So it's still out there.
That's
cool. So that's probably what we're going to do. So don't worry. Like, we're not going to it's not going to cease to exist, but we're definitely not paying any money.
Yeah.
Anymore after this. If you think you don't even like our show, tell them they got 3 episodes left. So you can still follow us on Twitter at MGT Podcast, Instagram and Facebook. Don't know what those are going to do. They'll be around something. This feels weird. We still want to thank our great and powerful sponsor, Nan, not David Morgan, who destroyed the show. I love you, buddy. You want to come on? Hey, Dave, I want to come over and eat pizza. You have that new pizza oven that you just made? Do that. Let's do that. You can also visit our website, mgtpodcast.com, where you can visit the actual sponsors page and purchase an item from Range Outdoors. Ready? Go.
Go.
Be.
Free.
Free.
That was terrible.
That was horrible.
Wow.
We are.
I was messing with my phone.
Podcast over. Podcast over. MGT logo designed by Mary Madewell, Home Tree logo designed by Dan Nicholson, and of course, for now, we're proud members of the Podfix Network. Go to podfixnetwork.com, follow us at Podfix on Twitter. So, I'm gonna ride my horse down the old town road.
That was a disco move that you were just doing.
Ride till I can't.
That's what he does when he's thinking. He doesn't step into space. He just does some random gesture.
I know, right?
That doesn't make sense.
Bye for me, Chris. Bye for me, Chris. And Corey.
Peace.
And Donnie.
Happy trails.
Nice. That was really good. Network. You can check out more shows like it at oddfixnetwork.com.